Yeah, good afternoon students. Welcome back to our class, that is brand management, brand and product management. Now we'll go with our synopsis, I mean our presentations. Now our today's topic is brand repositioning. What are the reason, factors and strategies of brand repositioning? First we will have the meaning. What does it mean? Brand repositioning is when a company changes a brand status in the marketplace. This typically includes changes to the marketing mix such as product, price, place and promotion. Repositioning is done to keep up with consumer wants and needs. See here in the common parlance, it has been mentioned clearly that why the repositioning of the brand will take place for the sake of fulfilling the needs and wants of the customers and consumers. Now another thing is that what are the reason are there to make the repositioning of the brand? What are the factors or what are the strategies? What makes the company or the organization to change the brand name or the logo or the status? We will have a deep explanation one by one. Now we'll go to the second image or the second position. See, when we are going for the underperforming product, when the product is going to be manufactured, what are the things should have to be manufactured? We should have to improve our product. How? Then the second stage will be there in the market, launching the new product. When we are launching the new product, do nothing. Like what are the things, something you have to do, like for example, for milk product, what are the things should have to be done, what are the things should not be done. Then withdraw, that means what are the things we should have to withdraw from our product. But depending on that, like the defects or the effects or the negative impact in the customer's minds, we have to remove or withdraw the things or the features from our product. Then modify it, what are the things are needed. That means sometimes in the last class, we also discuss about when the product is going in the decline stage from maturity stage, then the company should have to modify it or they should have to withdraw the some features in the product so that again it can run for the long term in future in the business. And the last one is repositioning the brand. Here it comes. Now what does it mean? The brand reposition refers to the change in the weak position of brand according to the change in the customer's perception of brand in order to reach the target market effectively. It helps in increase in sales. So why the reposition of brand takes place? Because to increase in sales, sometimes what will happen, the products will not be there in the good performance, the appearance is not good. If I take an example of Colgate powder, tooth powder, what is in 1980s, how the tooth powder looks like, then why they have changed it, what are the new things they have added in it according to the customer needs and wants, then they have slowly changed the brand. So what are the character, what are the factors, reasons? Let's have a look in this matter. Now another thing, for example, like Cadbury Dairy Milk is there. Advertisement earlier, it focused more on children as their target customers. So who are the target customers for the Cadbury Dairy Milk? Children. Later what happened, when the children market saturated, the response was not in good position, then what happened? The thing was here that they reposition it there to the young youth. That means they reposition there by emphasizing on the young youth as target customers, like the students got pass in the examinations or any festival moment takes place, then this Cadbury comes in the market like kuch meetha ho jaye. Now another thing, after that, now this product has been positioned it for the whole family as a traditional mithai. Nowadays when all the festivals are taking place, the people are distributing or exchanging of sweets or the gifts in the form of a Cadbury big chocolate or a Cadbury Dairy Milk, whatever it may be. So what is their main intention? To bring the sales should have to get increased. This is the main motto or the vision of the company. So what they have done, just they have repositioned it from children to the whole family or the young youth also. Like kuch meetha ho jaye. For example, in the advertisement you may have seen that a new couple comes to the grandparents' house. So what they happen, they don't have sweets. So then what they say, just they had bring some Cadbury and they kept in their mouth and they welcome into their houses. So not only that, when a person is going for a new job, when he got the job offer, then the parents are giving him, they used to keep some sweet in the mouth. That is a tradition. So on behalf of some keeping some sweet, they are keeping this Cadbury Dairy Milk in the mouth, and it has become a usage. It's a wants and needs of the customer nowadays because of the repositioning of the brand, just of this, because from the children's they have given the advertisement. That means they have repositioned in the advertisement also. First they used to target to the children's, now they are targeting to the young youth and the whole family. So this is the main example I can say for understanding our topic, that is brand repositioning. Now we will go for the next term. What are the reasons? Reasons of repositioning. Now, the first thing is, brand repositioning is undertaken when brands intend to change their target market segments. Another one, brand repositioning is also done in order to motivate consumers to buy the products. Yes, so to motivate the customers, to motivate our product in the minds of the customers, this brand repositioning is helping to increase the sale. Not only that, the first point they had mentioned that when brands intend, that means its intention is to change the target market segmentations. Now from this target market, from demographic to the geographical, so it will help them to reposition in the market. Now brand repositioning makes easier for people to buy from you, that means from the company, in order to highlight the superiority of the existing brand and brand positioning. Not only repositioning helps in the existing, but also it will help in positioning the brand in the market, in the minds of the customer too. And one more point, brand repositioning enables you to compete on value, not price. That means it will bring the value to your product on behalf of the price. Yes, the last point in the brand positioning repositioning is that it justifies price strategies. For example, for building contemporary images, that means brand repositioning also helps in making the contemporary images in the minds of the customers, improve offerings. Sometimes you'll get the offers from the suppliers, by the customers, or by the manufacturers unit also. Entering into the new market, that means depending on the time to time or situation, when you just change or repositioning your brand, sometimes you can enter into the new market or into present market from time to time, or by the celebrity, or by person to person, or by the need and wants of the customers in the market. Now how all these figures are taking place, we will have a look in our next slides. Now what is the factors of the brand repositioning? Now the following are the various factors for brand repositioning. We are having four factors of brand repositioning. Among them, the first one is contemporary image. What does it mean? Contemporary image is nothing but this brand. This is also one of the first factor of brand repositioning, and the contemporary image is visible in the form of consumers' usage and observation. See, here one picture is there. In the first picture, this is the modern one, what where the people are there, and this one here you can see the contemporary image. Just changes has been taken place in the house. That means the same thing, we are having the sofa set, windows are there, the light lamp is there, bedroom lamp is there, but we don't have the things. Now if you see in this picture, what is happening here, some changes are there. If you see here, so the picture is there, we are having, this means it's the old one and the new one. See the pattern, how it is changing place. Or this one, some people will go for this one to this one, or from this one to this one, where we are having a small portrait, a piggy is there for saving of money, a small what we can say power recovering is there, a small flower vase is there. All these designers, by seeing this, we can see the small changes. That means contemporary issues, images will be there, which is useful for taking the decision. Now the second one is decision. That means here decisions related to repositioning. The second one is the decisions related to the reposition. This is also one of the factor of brand repositioning. Why this factor has become an important? Because the decision, sometimes the decision to connect to Repositioning are concerned with strength of the brand or competitive aspects and perception of the consumer. See what will happen in the market when our competitors have launched a product with new features and those new features are not there with our existing product, then we have to take the decisions to go for the repositioning in the market. So because of this is one competitive aspect, sometimes it will go for the perception of the consumer. How the consumer will go for the perception? See, it is the thinking of the customer, either they have to go for that which product they have to select and which one they should have to obligate. So if you want to run our product in the market for the long term, it's our duty that we have to go for seeing the customers or consumers' perception and by taking the feedback from the customer. So it is our duty to go for the perception of the customers in a short span of time. Now another thing is with the strength of a brand, what is our strength, what are the weakness, what are the opportunities we are getting and what are the threat it is there. That means that is known as SWOT analysis, which we have done in our last classes. Now so we should have by to make the strength once again to build the good name and fame and to stay in the market. Sometimes the managers or the decision maker people will take the decisions related to the repositioning of our brand. So here is one picture so that you can able to understand what does it mean. See here, first one is brand position. We have to mention that and what are the benefits, that means what are the attributes of the brand positioning, you know, what are the benefits, beliefs and values. That means why the brand is there, because the customers will have the attributes and they will know about the benefits of the product, they know about they are going to have the belief and values and they will blindly they will trust on your product. Now why the brand name selection would take place? For protection and for selection in the market. Now brand sponsorship will be there either by the manufacturer's brand, private brand, licensing, co-branding. Now brand development, line extensions, brand extensions, multi-brands, new brands, all these things we have covered in our last topic or in the last class. So I don't want to waste your time here, just to make you understand that why the decision, if we are finding any sort of things missing in these in the market, to fulfill that gap or to fulfill that path, we are going to take the decision for the repositioning of our brand in the market. Now the third one is, it's nothing but timing of repositioning. See what is nothing by what is mean by timing of repositioning is, it is essential to retain the leading position of the brand by seeing the time and the situation of our product in the market. We have to change our brand or we have to go for it. For example, Iodex has repositioned by Move. Now what the cream we are getting for there is a proverb in Jodon Kadarz. So whatever the things are coming, Move, if you are keeping the Move, utilizing this, the same company, just they have repositioned by Iodex to Move. So many people are going for change in the market. They want a new changes, they want a new aspect, and the perception of the customers has been changed in the Move. So they are utilizing, the formula is same, the manufacturers are same, just they have changed the name and a little bit logo and the ingredients in that, and they are posting that, and the pattern of the product, size, weight, price. Now Dove has been responsible as a moisturizing soap. Before that Dove has a small soap, but it has become a moisturizing soap for the women's. They have targeted to those. So by seeing the time to time, we have to change our product. That is nothing but our brand is going to get the reposition it once again. If you are not looking into our product, which is positioning in a proper way, which is not positioning in the right way, so we have to reposition it in a proper way by adding some features in the product or by changing some brand name or by adding some advertisement skills, so that once again it can come up in the market for the long run. Now we'll go for the fourth term, that is for explaining of timing of repositioning. I am just showing you here one picture. See, this is the Colgate tooth powder. It consists of, in 1990s, this powder, that means tooth powder, used to come in this tin box in this pattern way. And after this, in the modern way, you can see here how the same thing, the Colgate tooth powder is there. See the picture, how they have designed, what is the color they are having, what is the main message they want to give, what is their philosophy, what is their trademark logo, all these things are there, what is the weight 200 grams, everything they had mentioned. So by seeing the timing only, from as the days are passing day by day, we have to change our products features also, so that the product repositioning will take place as well as the brand repositioning also takes place. Colgate is very old. See here how it looks like. This is the brand logo of the olden days. Now just see how the package and labeling has taken place. Because of these changes in the market, we are going to attract to our customers, and our customers will be loyal for our product forever. So by seeing, this is nothing but we are repositioning our product by timingly. According to the timing, we are just slightly changing. One more example I can give, Maruti, that is cars. Maruti 800 car in 1980s and 90s, how it was? It was just a small car. Now, how many as the cars are developing more and more and they are involving into the market, that much demand is not there for the Maruti car. How other cars are having a demand in the market, because they have changed according to the timingly. We have to change or reposition our product in the market. Now we will go for the fourth one, that is a change of the target market segmentation. That what does it mean? The reason for changes of target market segmentation is because of consumers' perception with respect to offering and price and other brand association. Like as I have given the example of Cadbury Dairy Milk is a good example. According to the situation, according to the offering, respect to the offering and prices and brand associations, the change of target market segment should have to go from early. That means they have targeted first to the children, now again they have targeted to the young youth, now they have targeted to the whole family. No age bar is there, everyone is utilizing that in a proper way. So this is the strategy, or this is the factor we can say that they have taken into the market. That means the marketer should have to follow this factor, and they have to follow this strategy for building up or repositioning their brand in the market for the sake of increase in the sale, so that they can earn more profit and the business of the that company can run for long term in future. Now we will go for another part. How this is, that means what is the total market? Who are our non-consumers? Who are low-level consumers? Who are medium level consumers, who are high level value consumers, who are ex customers. All this data is here. We have to focus on it, and we can get the target. That means target market segmentation will be divided in these criteria. Now, next one, brand repositioning strategies. This is the third topic. Brand, how the strategies will take place, what are the strategies which should have to take place for making repositioning of our brand. For there we are having six are there. Among them, the first one is segment oriented repositioning, symbolizing oriented repositioning, niche oriented repositioning, value oriented repositioning, celebrity oriented and brand enhancements repositioning, and last one is app technology oriented repositioning. Now we'll learn one by one what does it mean, how it affects to our brand repositioning. Just students, have a look here. As I was mentioning, please observe here. The first one, we will go for segment oriented repositioning. What do you mean by segmenting? Dividing the market. Now as we have learned in our last class or in our first sem, what do you mean by segmentation? Now I don't want to waste your time. Here we will go for the segment oriented repositioning strategy is adopted by a brand which want to change its target market segment. For example, Sunny two wheelers, it's a two wheeler bike was there, which was at the early, when it was at the beginning stage of that product, the target segment of Sunny two wheelers was for teenagers, and it was with 60cc, but it failed. Again the Sunny, they had repositioned it as, and they have just changed the name. Changing of the name of the brand took place, like Sunny Zip is introduced for women. Who are those women? Women who are going for colleges or universities, that means degree, PG and university courses students, they have targeted. Married women, the women who can, who want to drive nearby their houses, all these things. I will show you the picture so that it can be able to understand easily, and it has was become successful because of this segmenting oriented process. the reposition of the brand took place and it got success. So let's have the look over here. And now here, this is the price. This is the old picture of the Sun Inn. See, here is a bag where the children can go and keep it. Now once again, I'll go for the modern one. How this lady is taking the bike, I mean this zip is taking place. That means Sunny Zip is taking place. The new moderation, they have added some new features to their bike and they are riding on the road. So because of this idea, the segmentation we need, that means because of this brand repositioning, the segment took place and the company is able to run till now in the market for business. Now we'll go for the second one, that is symbolism oriented repositioning. What is symbolism? Symbol is nothing but lives like a brand or a name or a logo or a symbol which will be identified by the customer for its brand. Now symbolism oriented repositioning is adopted when a brand having strong entrenched functional image intend to expand its market using symbolic positioning without losing its previous association. That means whatever the already it is there in the market without losing its previous association, once again it is getting some more attracted in the market or some more values will be built up in the market, and because of that symbolism, because of that symbol, the people or the customers are purchasing and are becoming the loyal customers to the brand. So how does it takes place? If I take an example of Raymond Textile, targeted to well-dressed male person in early at the beginning position with high price and high competition with number of outlets in the nation, means in the country there were so many outlets are there where they are, you can see Raymond shooting and setting. Because of these, well, they have targeted to the well-dressed people, but 10 years back Raymond has repositioned itself as a fabric for the complete man. For the Raymond's, a complete man, they used to have this slogan of their logo. So that means when a person who is wearing this textile, that means that totally they are targeting to the male segmentation, male category person, and a gender priority giving to the gender. So the many people are following this brand for the long term. This offering highlights for family experience in life. So whenever the family is going for the shopping, they give importance to the brand, that is the Raymond's, and all the family members are taking the clothes or the shopping, they are doing the Raymond's itself only. Whereas it is already a symbol of the good, but this repositioning from a well-dressed man to a complete man, because of this slogan, more sale was coming in some family showroom. Now if you just see this picture, in this picture you are mentioning totally this family showroom where you are not only getting the textiles of remnants of only men, but also the children's are the male category, and sometimes now they are getting female, for females also they are mentioning here. So this brand repositioning is bringing the concept of improvement of sale in the minds of the customer. So you can observe here. Now we'll go for the niche marketing. What does it mean? Niche oriented repositioning. In the last class we discussed about niche marketing. Once again I'll just give a brief knowledge about it. Niche marketing is defined as channeling all marketing efforts towards one well-defined segment of the population. That means targeting to a specific concern of people among the audience. There is one important thing to understand, that niche does not exist, but is created by small marketing techniques and identifying what the customer wants. Niche oriented repositioning strategies adopted when a niche brand wanted to expand its target market after creating brand awareness. For example, Dove soap. At beginning the size of the soap was small. Dove tried to reposition it in the market by introducing the brand in the market as a moisturizing soap. So what is the soap is recognized nowadays by moisturizing soap, and they have targeted most of the female gender, youngsters and women, children. That means the household, the head of the family is the mother, and she's listening to her daughter who are going to the colleges or who are at the adolescent stage or at the adulthood. So they are targeting to those people. The company is, by just repositioning its brand from a soap to a moisturizing soap, so the sale is high in the market. So that is the reason we are there targeted by a particular segmentation. This is nothing but niche oriented repositioning. See here, this is a picture of the old house of how it used to be there, and this is because of beauty cream. Just it is for beauty cream. The beauty will be shine on the face of the person who is applying this. Now we will go for the another slide. That is the Dove Go Fresh Fresh Moisture with the cucumber, and that means they are adding, and this is the dermatologist number one. Here it has been mentioned, the logo, the brand is having the slogan on it. So the people are using, that means the company or the organizations of the brand are targeting to a segment population that is nothing but the female gender by just repositioning his brand from a beauty soap to a fresh moisture show. Now we'll go for the next one. That is the value oriented repositioning. It is, that means value oriented repositioning always comes in two cases. That means it is adopted in two cases. The first one is when a brand has strongly built a value proposition, and when a brand is offering value in competition with the unorganized sector. For example, how it takes place. See what we are talking. We are talking that here the brand has strongly built a value proposition. If once the value is there in the market, then we are able to reposition the brand for the long term. Or when the brand offering value is competing with the unorganized sector, when our product is going with competition with this unorganized sector, then value of oriented repositioning should have to take place. For example, in India, manufacturers of loose oils are leading the edible oil market. Loose oil is not a branded one. Wendy is a brand of edible oil which is distributed to consumers through a vending machine without any packaging. Distribution through Wendy machine differs from other brands. If you check here, if I show you the picture, see a man is going on. In the olden days, we used to get the edible oil which we don't have any kind of brand or the company. Just we go and the people used to get the oil from the vending shop or some nearby local supplier of the oil, edible oil. But now this has been, the value has came, like Saffola is a natural, gold drops, sunflower, all these are the oils where they are getting oil drops, that means edible oil in a valued one packaging, that means because of the reposition, because of this vending machine has not been mentioned in a value added or value oriented positioning in by a particular name or a brand. So now you are seeing this, the edible oil used to be here openly, they used to sell, but now what is happening? See here, I will show you. There is no name, no brand name. In the olden days, they used to sell this market, a product like this. And this is the same thing. They used to say, that means sunflower oil, how it used to be. Now, by filtering and by having some values, they are packing in such a way and labeling in such a way that it is, it has become a value-oriented brand repositioning. So nowadays, people are purchasing 5 liters of jar or the box for their household things. So this has become, this is also one reason that we can say that this is a strategy because of value added orientation. We have to improve our product so that we can change up. Because of brand repositioning only, the sale has been improved or the sale has been increased. Now, if I take another example of this, like sunflower oil, natural oil also. These are the some examples I can say. Now we'll go for the another term, that is celebrity oriented brand. Sometimes the brand will be run because of the celebrity. If I take an example of Amitabh Bachchan, so Navratan hair oil. So like this, that means because of the celebrity only, because of just changing the person. So what is happening? The people are confident to purchase because a very big personality is, or celebrity is confirm about this product and is able to use that. Why should not we? You should have to use. Or else it is attracting to the customers to purchase it from the company or the organization. Now we'll have an enhancement. Celebrity oriented brand enhancement is adopted when a brand makes use of imagery to stiffen its association and try to enter new market segment on the basis of strength of the same imagery. Now example, BPR Electronics TVs Now, how in 1980s and 1990s, the first product of BPL is TV, television, electronics. But now the BPL has become a celebrity and it has given so many other products like Godrej TV, Godrej washing machine, Godrej refrigerator. All these things are coming into the market slowly by changing its, that means the celebrity oriented brand. So these are the main causes. If I show you the old TV, that means BPL TV, see it's looking like a dabba TV nowadays, the people are saying, in the OLX it is ready to say it. Now if I show you the next picture, this is how the people, that means how they are going to get the promotion. And this is one more thing. Now this is the LED, how the LED TVs are coming off BPL. See how many, that means 42 inches, 72 inches, 70mm screens are also coming center. So because of celebrity, because of this IPL match, the IPL matches also, now they are getting, the players are getting the t-shirts of that company, BPL or Daikin or some other company. So this strategy is making to build up the celebrity or to promote the product of the company. And this is bringing the change in the customer's minds about the product quality, or it's like a reminder in the minds of the customer for purchasing or to be remember when in future they are in need of the product. Now we will go for the next one, that is the upmarket orientation repositioning. That means it is adopted when a brand targeting a down market consumer's intent or its intention to expand its coverage to markup consumer. See what is happening, it is targeting at down market consumers who are not willing or whose intention is to expand its coverage to up market consumers. So market will be two types, one is down market, one is the up market. In the down market the sale will be not in a huge way, but whereas it coming to the up market it will be in the huge way. So the company tried to bring the down market people into the consumers to the up market consumers. Now for example, Pond is a famous brand. The repositioning of itself as a screen care brand with technology and research associations brought the strategies and its help points in stretching its market to upper end consumers. So what happened in the after time being, the there was no advertisements or the sale promotion from the Pond's brand. So what happened, they start again, they repositioned the product itself and they had mentioned it as a skincare. So many people nowadays they are using Pond's powder as for the skincare, like for a small glow on their face or it look like fresh for them, what it may be. Now if you go for the next one, is changes of image oriented repositioning. It is adopted when a brand wants to change its image in the market. For example, Maruti car at the beginning in 1980s were not able to purchase by middle class people. With passing of time, so many brands of car have involved or evolved. Huge competition grabbed down the value of Maruti 800. Maruti repositioned itself as a car for middle class people. This repositioning changed the image of the brand without affecting the economy offerings of the brand. So as we can understand that nowadays what's happening, the Maruti car which was in huge demand in 1980s, slowly gradually the demand has been decreased as many new cars or the new brands of car making or the manufacturers used to come and involve in the market. So the value has been down. In 1980s, there was a huge demand that high class people used to purchase, but now middle class people or low middle class people are able to purchase the Maruti 800 cars where it is not affecting the economics of the brand. So it is running and now it is not there. So they are going with some other new products. So it is the duty of the manager or the company authorized person or oriented persons to take the proper decision at the right time for repositioning the brand in the market. So at last, in the conclusion, I can say what the things we learned in today's class. In the today's class, we learned that why brand should be repositioned once again in the market. So what are the factors, what are the reasons, and what are the strategies are there in this topic we learn with pictures and explanation. I hope students you understand the topic. Have a nice day. Thank you. And have a small request, please subscribe or mention your attendance register in the comment box. Thank you.